Welcome to my grow life channel. In this video I will show you the cure of croton plants and their disease control. Pests on croton plants. Deer. Crotons are typically deer resistant. So there is no problematic to plant croton on your garden. Most of the major pests of crotons can be avoidable by regularly cleaning plant leaves with neem oil and fresh water. It's difficult to detect spider mites because of the color of the plants, as they leave yellow spots on leaves. Remove mites with a damp paper towel and discourage recurring infestations by keeping leaves clean. Sulfur-based insecticide can prevent mites in disease. Discourage plant scale by cleaning leaves weekly with neem oil and water. Remove mealybugs with a burst of water from the hose by placing a cottonball dipped in rubbing alcohol on the bugs. Tips. Consider planting a variety of croton species in a grouping to highlight the variety of the plant. Not only will you have a bright colorful showing, but also the distinctive leaf shape of the different varieties will be unusual. Fertilizer. Fertilize outdoor crotons 3 times a year with a granular fertilizer. Burned leaves or leaves with gray patches may indicate a sunburn. Move the plant to a shadier location during the hottest part of the day. In normal variety, twisted leaves indicate too much fertilization. Scale back fertilization from 3 to 2 fertilizations per year. Pruning. Trim crotons as necessary to keep the size manageable, using sterilized clippers. Trim stems only, not cutting into the actual leaf. Pruning often encourages new growth in crotons. Prune areas where you want to see more growth. Encourage a bushier look by pruning or snipping off the growing portion of each stem. Cut just above nodes or leaves to help maintain the shape of your plant. Remove diseased or rotten stems completely, cutting all the way back to the central stem. Resist cutting back too much of the plant at one time, never more than 1/3 of the total plant, or you could shock the plant. Avoid pruning the plant again until new growth has formed. Consider wearing gloves when pruning crotons, as they emit a white sap where cut are damaged. The sap is considered a toxin and may cause a rash. Avoid touching your eyes or mouth if you have made contact with the sap, or it may cause a serious reaction such as nausea, diarrhea, or vomiting. Wash hands thoroughly after exposure to sap. Warnings. Crotons tend to be shocked easily when moved from one location to another. The shock in temperature or light may result in a loss of leaves. Don't worry though, as this is a normal behavior of crotons. Maintain regular care of the plant, monitoring water, humidity, and light levels. Keep humidity levels high by misting the plant with a water bottle or by placing the pot on a pebble tray with water.